The home court of the Toronto Raptors filled to capacity. Welcome to the NBA playoffs here on 2K Sports. It's game five. Hi, everyone. This is Kevin Harlan with Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. Our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. You look at the Raptors. With the series tied two games apiece, a chance here to retake the series lead and put themselves in the driver's seat.
No secret here, guys, that in this situation, the winner of Game 5 goes on to win the series the vast majority of the time. So they want to take care of business here and avoid a do-or-die Game 6 in hostile territory.
Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. A starting five on the floor. So on the floor for Philadelphia. Simmons runs the show with Redick at the two. Tobias Harris is out there with Embiid, and it's Butler at the small forward. And so it's the Raptors getting on the board first. And it's Simmons penetrating. Rebound by the Raptors. They come into the game following the win on Sunday.
And always tough on the road, but that attack mindset that they brought offensively, I really felt like that set them apart.
Well, also great execution. Let's not forget about that. Being active gets you only so far if you lack the discipline.
And Philadelphia has possession. After Toronto picking up the basket just moments ago. And the officials call him for a 3-second violation. The Raptors have gone 2-3 here to start out the game. We play just over a minute here in the first. Pass to Leonard. Clock at 4. Poked away. Outside, Simmons. Here's Harris, and slam dunk by Harris.
This is what a point guard should do. Simmons is so adept at noticing when the defense is overcommitted.
Simmons against Lowry. Outside Gasol. Here's Siakam. Misses the three. Philadelphia with the ball. And David Aldridge spoke with Nick Nurse. David.
I asked him what he emphasized to his team, and he told me it all comes down to wanting it more. Who wants it more? Game 5 is going to be a tooth-and-nail fight. You want to win this series, you leave nothing on the table. Kevin, we'll see if his players can back that talk up. We'll see. Back to you.
Thank you, David.
This is as high percentage of a shot as you can get for Embiid. He's a powerhouse of a player. He loves to dunk.
Siakam kicks to Green. And Leonard has it in the corner. Over Butler. And it's Leonard missing.
The D a little slow to get in his face. They're fortunate it didn't cost him.
Redick with the three. No good that time. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Leonard looking over the floor. Lowry for three. His second shot goes in. Off to a good start. 2 for 2.
And, guys, this is what you like to see early on, gaining a little confidence from range.
Well, I wouldn't say that's his shot, but it's a shot he can make. And that really opens things up for the offense.
Here's Green. 76ers getting the bucket. Outside Lowry. The three. Redick with the rebound. The 76ers have gone 50% from the field, hitting 3 of 6 since the opening tip. He kicks to Simmons. Outside Butler from outside the arc. It's up and it's off the mark. He's 0 for 1. Toronto's gone 1 of 3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Philadelphia's gone 0 of 3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. And the wide-open shot from Redick. Here's Harris, and that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Kyle Lowry picks one up there.
Oh, wow. And Harris is a guy that really offers a ton of versatility. He can play both forward spots and is an efficient scorer from just about anywhere.
The 76ers shooting their first free throws of the evening. tees it up, and this next one could give them the lead.
Some changes for Toronto. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Gasol. Norman Powell comes in for Leonard. And it's Fred VanVleet in for Kyle Lowry. Then for the 76ers, Marjanovic checked in for Joel Embiid. Mike Scott comes in for J.J. Redick. And it's T.J. McConnell in for Simmons. And that drops, so they now lead by one.
And once he gets into a groove like that, you can just count.
So timeout called here, the first for Toronto.
Yeah, you know, some of it's shot selection, some just bad luck, and they just can't get anything going.
Well, this is the dilemma as a coach. You wonder, do I need to call a timeout here? Do I need to settle these guys down? Should I let them play through it?
Ennis, he's checked in for Philadelphia. .153 left to play in the first quarter. VanVleet kicks to Powell. Ibaka against Marjanovic. Ibaka, no luck. The 76ers lead. Ennis taking his time here. And the rejection by Ibaka.
An elite rim protector, Ibaka has the highly desired combination of athleticism and timing.
Good on the bucket. Powell's got his first points of the night.
That's just too easy. I mean, you can't let him post you like that.
Well, yeah, you want to try to deny, take something away, but you can also see he's smart about his position.
Now, here's McConnell. Tries to shoot. From deep three-point range, and they force the shot clock violation. Great team. And here's Green. He'll bring it up for the Raptors. 43 seconds left to play here in the first. The shot by Powell, no good.
And that's letting the defense off the hook. No excuse for blowing that layup.
The 76ers again can't hit it. Raptors with the lead. Outside, Green. Back to VanVleet. Shot clock at 5. Here's Siakam. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Left side, Butler. One quarter in the books, and it's been a close one so far. Toronto ahead, leading by a point. And we'll get things started in the second quarter when we return. Marquee matchup tonight. Jimmy Butler says he loves to go up against the best.
I'm one that if you're the best in the world, I want to see it. And I wake up for these games. I want to know, how do you do it? And you're going to have to do it every night when you go up against me.
That's the hardworking mentality Butler provides, a two-way threat, Greg, who wants to dominate the top players at his position.
And Butler's really embraced being a leader. You can tell he lives for these types of matchups and games.
And we welcome you back here to the broadcast of the Eastern Conference Semifinals. And what do you guys think about the Raptors here so far in this one?
I think they play great D and not giving up anything easy early on.
Yeah, closing down the lane, closing out on perimeter shooters. Interesting first quarter.
They've got Powell. Green out there with Ibaka. And Siakam in at the foreshot. That's the group for Toronto to start the second quarter. Now here's Butler. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Shoots over Powell. And trying for the go-ahead basket, it doesn't go in. To the middle, here's VanVleet. It's hauled in by the 76ers.
Oh, sloppy finish. The D was giving him the layup. He just didn't stay with it.
That's a two from Powell. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Powell's got the first points up on the board here in the second quarter for the Raptors. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
McConnell scanning the floor. Mojanovic, no good. Raptors leading by three. Inside, Powell. Scott pulls it in. The 76ers have gone 0-3 and are still looking for that first bucket here in the second quarter. Now the pass to McConnell. Outside, Scott. Outside, Butler. Shoots over Powell. Here's Mojanovic, and he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
And you just hate to give up those second chance points.
It can be discouraging, frustrating, but you only have yourselves to blame. Box out.
And the Raptors call time here. Some changes for Toronto. Marc Gasol has checked in for Siakam. Leonard comes in for Danny Green. And it's Kyle Lowry in for Fred VanVleet. And Philadelphia will go for a different look here. Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Mojanovic. Harris comes in for Ennis. J.J. Redick's checked in for Jimmy Butler. And Simmons subbed in for T.J. McConnell. Now here's Powell. After Ben Simmons miss, the offensive rebound. Leonard with the bucket.
And he's got the athleticism and strength to be a powerful presence inside. Leonard never afraid to get in and mix it up down low.
Now here's Redick. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. To the paint. And stolen by Kyle Lowry. Now the Raptors moving it up. Not going to go that time. Now the 76ers take it the other way. Redick inside the line. The 76ers again can't hit it.
Yeah, that's just poor decision-making. He's got to be better in those situations.
I'd love to hear his explanation to coach right there. I mean, that should be an interesting conversation.
Now here is Lowry. He has five. Six to shoot. And Leonard has it in the corner. Sinks the three-pointer. Leonard's got five now.
And that's what you give up when you don't fight over the screen.
A lot of times your defense is your offense. Your offense is your defense. This is poor decision-making right here. You can't let them have that shot. Also, might have been a lack of effort.
Yeah, and there it is again. On a lot of their possessions this first half, they've established great inside position.
Raptors leading by four. Here's Powell. Kicks to Lowry. Puts it up. And Joel Embiid pulls it down.
They haven't been able to count on his scoring tonight, but still, here they are in the lead.
Harris, Leonard with the steal. Fast break. Here come the Raptors. A shot by Lowry. Wide open. Off target with the open look. The 76ers trail by four. Down low. And Harris gets it to go on the assist from Redick. 8 points for Tobias Harris.
Whether it's inside or outside, Harris remains steady and ready to shoot the ball. He definitely has the trust of his teammates and coaches.
Now here's Leonard. Right side, Gasol. Off the left rim and up.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
Harris looking it over. Shot clock at six. And they're unable to get the tying basket there. Here's Leonard. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Leonard's got his third basket of the night.
That's his mindset. Attack, attack, attack whenever possible.
Harris inside. He's covered by Leonard. A fadeaway. And all around the rim that time before dropping in.
And the touch Embiid has on his jumper, I mean, looking so soft and accurate, coming out of his hands.
Passes it to Ibaka. He kicks it to Leonard. Knocked loose, 11 feet away, and Embiid pulls it down. Embiid's got four rebounds now tonight. Redick with the three. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Leonard with the ball. And a deep three from Lowry. And that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in.
Oh, a versatile defender who can guard at any position. Simmons, he's using his speed and length to annoy shooters.
So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. 76ers lead by one. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
Much different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, David. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after this break.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. This is Ernie Johnson, along with Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. We hope you're enjoying this round two conference semifinal. Taking a look at the 76ers, they have yet to take control of this series or the game. We know the team that wins game five of a series that's tied 2-2 is often the one to advance, so they need to be at their best in the second half. And from what we saw so far from the Sixers, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
Really great rebounding effort, Ernie, so far. They're putting up some nice numbers in that category. That's the big difference in the first half.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on Toronto?
Well, the low turnovers really stood out to me. They didn't get loose with it or make silly passes. Nothing was forced. They had a nice flow to the offense. Guys knew where to be on the floor. That's the heads-up style of play they need to bring in the second half.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
The evening commute has plenty of people on the move here tonight in Toronto, where we welcome you back. And thanks for joining us once more as we get set to continue our coverage of the Eastern Conference Semis. Nice game, great performance by Harris.
His points production thus far, off the charts. It's only been two quarters, just a great effort for him for the entire half.
Yeah, right. I mean, the defense hasn't had an answer for this guy yet. Just too skilled, too driven this far.
And we're back here at game five as we get things started once more. And Simmons has got the ball here for the 76ers. They lead by one. And so in the game for the 76ers, Simmons runs the show with Redick at the two. Joel Embiid out there with Harris. And it's Butler in at the small forward. Now here's Butler. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. A three from Simmons. Toronto grabs the miss. Siakam's got six rebounds here tonight. Here's Leonard. That one drops for him. Leonard's got the first basket of the second half here for Toronto. Leonard's gone 50% shooting tonight, firing away 4 of 8. And Simmons kicks to Harris. Pass to Butler. Philadelphia moving the ball. And the officials calling for a 3-second violation. And now let's give you a look at the players who have stood out and taking high percentage shots in the playoffs. Fifth on the list, Ben Simmons.
And guys, that shooting percentage of his has been spectacular since the start of the playoffs. He has been completely locked in.
Pass to Gasol. Good D by Embiid.
Now that's what we're talking about in terms of the activity level defensively. You got to protect the rim.
Well, that takes physical ability, good timing, those two things that he possesses.
Now here's Simmons. The shot by Butler. Nobody around. And a miss there on the triple. Lowry from outside. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
Oh, that's just a lack of communication. Two guys just not on the same page.
Fred VanVleet is checked in for Kyle Lowry. Third quarter of basketball. We're about a minute and a half in. And Simmons kicks to Butler. Down low. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Very difficult to deal with inside. I mean, once Embiid gets the positioning he wants, you almost have to foul.
The 76ers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Gentlemen, two shots. Loose shots.
The free throw drops for Embiid.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Cal. And there's no question. When Embiid is healthy, he's a problem. I mean, a versatile, confident big man with a high ceiling.
The 76ers making a switch here. McConnell's checked in. And Embiid drops them both.
What an advantage for a big man to have that smooth stroke at the line.
And the Raptors call time here.
Yeah, you know, some of it's shot selection, some just bad luck, and they just can't get anything going.
Well, this is the dilemma as a coach. You wonder, do I need to call a timeout here? Do I need to settle these guys down? Should I let them play through it?
Toronto trailing. And there's the pass to Leonard. Here's Siakam. Passes it to Gasol. Here's Siakam. Guarded by Embiid. Just five to shoot. Leonard, that's for two. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Butler's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Kicks it to Simmons. Harris outside. For three. There's Embiid. And terrific work on the offensive glass, and he picks up two. Embiid's got four this quarter.
They needed that. I mean, they were getting a little tense after starting the half 0 for 3.
Gasol passes to Van Vliet. He feeds it to Leonard. Over Butler. And again, no good by Toronto.
They haven't gotten their legs back. Just 1 for 4 to start the second half.
Here's Embiid, and Embiid throws it down.
Yeah, I mean, he's been orchestrating all game at a high level.
And you see defensively, when they try to patch something up, he exploits a different weakness.
Here's Van Vliet. He is still scoreless so far in this one. Gasol's in the post. Embiid's there. Gasol no good. The 76ers leading by 5. Here's McConnell. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got 6 assists in the game.
Loving the energy right now here in the third quarter as they try to take control of this game.
They came out the locker room refreshed. I mean, they've been the stronger team since halftime, no doubt. But it hasn't happened yet, but he's got time to find his rhythm. And if he does, they can turn this thing around quick.
Now, here's McConnell, guarded by Green. Simmons inside. Second chance shot, and it's good on the layup.
Timeout, timeout.
And now a 10-point 76ers lead.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Toronto calls timeout.
And he's been trying to do it all himself, and it's not working. Instead of forcing shots, you got to focus on moving the ball and keeping everybody involved.
Some changes for Toronto. Ibaka comes in for Marc Gasol. And it's Powell in for Danny Green. And then for Philadelphia, Marjanovic checked in for Embiid, and it's James Ennis in for Harris. Here's Van Vliet, still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Leonard, and the Raptors miss again.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now, massive.
He's lucky his teammates have picked up the slack for him. I mean, his shooting has been horrific.
1:33 left to play in the third. Siakam kicks to Leonard. Over Ennis. Leonard, no luck.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots.
And McConnell gets it to go.
Again and again, they're dissecting the defense and creating those high percentage looks from inside.
Pass to Ibaka. Outside Leonard. Pass to Van Vliet. And Siakam has it in the corner. No good. They had a chance to end the run there.
And they just tried everything to stem the tide here, but nothing seems to work.
Yeah, trying to recapture momentum. When the tide's running against you, very difficult to do. What will the young kids say today? Ride that wave.
Now here's Powell. Here's Leonard. It's stolen by Ennis. Now the 76ers on the break. Simmons is running. It's hauled in by the Raptors.
The struggles this quarter continue. The D's done a good job.
Now Leonard. 9 points in the game so far. Six on the shot clock. Beyond the arc. Sinks the triple. Leonard's got 5 points now in the quarter. And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers. Their lead at 11 points to end the quarter. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We come back right after this. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
And how about the floor generalship right here? I mean, showing us why they're always in good hands when he's the man in charge.
Great vision. He's a gifted passer. Has his finger on the pulse of this offense.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Raptors trail by 11. We've got Kawhi Leonard. Marc Gasol is out there with Lowry. And it's Van Vliet in at the two. That's the five out there for the Raptors. Back to Lowry. The three-pointer, no good.
Look, he's got to find better looks, so he's never going to pull out that funk he's in tonight.
Over to the left wing. Marjanovic kicks to Simmons. Back to Marjanovic. No good on that one. Good work defensively by Gasol. And there's the pass to Van Vliet. Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target. Now here's Simmons. Not a lot of room. Outside, Scott. Here's the three. Gasol with the rebound. And here's Lowry. He'll bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. Here's Leonard, not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down. Leonard's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Raptors. Simmons finds Redick. And here is Marjanovic. Now recovering, Simmons. It's good. And the 76ers lead by 11.
Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling now.
The drive by Lowry. Shooting foul. As the whistle blows, he'll shoot two free throws.
And I like how scrappy and aggressive Lowry is on the court. And it's easy to see how much his teammates enjoy playing alongside him.
And that one misses. The Raptors making a switch here. Green's checked in. Philadelphia also making some changes. Joel Embiid comes in for Marjanovic. And Tobias Harris subbed in for Ennis. And he sinks the second. Philadelphia leading by 10. And it's Simmons penetrating. He gets that one.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. One shot.
I mean, you got to love the skill set Simmons possesses. A nightly triple-double threat. He stuffs the stat sheet.
Simmons against Lowry. On the wing, Green. And again, Toronto no up. The 76ers have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Passes to Scott. Siakam pulls it in. Siakam's got 7 rebounds in the game. Harris against Leonard. Leonard draws the double. Pass to Siakam. Off the mark there with the 3-point shot. And it's Simmons penetrating. And Redick kicks to Harris. In the corner, Simmons with it. Lock at 6. Here's Scott. The basket good off the assist from Simmons.
And in the first half, it was a struggle offensively, shooting a very low percentage, but it hasn't prevented them from grabbing the lead, and now they're shooting it much better here in the second.
Pass to Embiid. Back to Simmons. The pass to Harris. He kicks to Redick. Philadelphia needs to get a shot off. Here's Simmons. Tries again. No good on the shot. 80 that time from Leonard.
Now, this has not been his best effort. He's lucky his teammates have been there to bail him out.
And he gives that rim a good tug on the way down.
Well, that's how you drive your point home right there. The 76ers leading by 14. Harris outside. To Simmons, and Simmons slams it in.
A problem inside. That's what he is. Once Simmons gets the ball in the positioning that he wants, he goes for the throwdown.
Toronto calls timeout.
Yeah, the amount of points they've given up here in the paint, that's what they got to talk about.
Ooh, this is ugly. No question about it. And you wonder if these matchups aren't favoring them right now.
And now we've got a moment for our Jordan player of the game, Ben Simmons.
And to me, the best part of his game has been the work he's done inside. I mean, slashing, driving the lane, attacking the basket at every chance. When he's had an opening, he's taken it.
With a chance to take command in the series, he did everything. That is the kind of killer instinct you need in the playoffs. Here's Siakam. Kicks to Lowry. It's to the inside, and there's the whistle on the shot. Took the foul, shot misses. He'll be shooting two. And Philadelphia gets called for the foul.
Shooting two, gentlemen.
Free throw drops for Gasol.
And the former second-round pick, Gasol's become an elite player at his position. He's a force at both ends.
That one is no good.
They'll take it, even with the miss. Anything they can do to cut into the lead.
Simmons against Lowry. Cross contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
And now they are probably too far ahead. It's going to be nearly impossible to get back in this one.
That's why you can't let yourself get in this deep a hole. Very little time now to climb up.
Some changes for Toronto. Serge Ibaka has checked in for Siakam. Norman Powell comes in for Leonard. And it's Fred VanVleet in for Kyle Lowry. Then for the 76ers, Marjanovic checked in for Joel Embiid. Ennis comes in for Jimmy Butler. And it's T.J. McConnell in for Tobias Harris. That's good from Simmons. 1:31 left in the fourth.
And guys, that's just about going to do it here for Game 5. Always pivotal. And now we look ahead to a critical Game 6. But a huge win tonight for the 76ers.
Starting five must have been happy to get so much help from the reserves in this game.
And they not only lightened the load, the subs did nothing less than guarantee a win.
And something we've come to almost expect is greatness from this guy. Such an overall great performance it was for Ben Simmons.
Well, of all the things he did well, his passing was the most important. He spread the ball around, kept everyone involved, and their offense clicked.
And how much longer are they going to keep that foot on the accelerator?
At this point, it's just icing on the cake. Terrific run closes it out.
Here's VanVleet outside for Gasol from downtown. Rebound by Ennis. And here is Simmons. 35 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Marjanovic, no good. Here's the Raptors with the ball. They trail by 18. The shot by Powell, no good. Now here's Simmons. So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. This was a pivotal game in the series so far, and they were able to keep their heads, Greg, get the job done, and take the all-important 3-2 lead.
Now they can breathe just a little bit easier, they're just one win away from closing this thing out. Had they lost this game, the pressure on them would have been huge.
Oh, just gigantic, you're right. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Jimmy, you have been outspoken about the need for maximum effort. Was it part of your plan to grab wins like the one we saw tonight?
It wasn't a part of my plan, but whatever works, works. I think we got a bunch of talented guys, and at times we forget how hard we got to play. On the road, at home, this is how we got to play basketball.
Jimmy, thanks for the time, man. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. It's time for us to say so long. We hope you've enjoyed our coverage during the second round of the NBA Eastern Conference Playoffs. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Chris Weber, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA on 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.